The Tom Woods Show, episode 1129.
Prepare to set fire to the index card of allowable opinion. Your daily dose of liberty education starts here. The Tom Woods Show.
Folks, Bob Murphy and I are doing it again. Contra Cruise 2018. You know you want to join us. You've seen how much fun it is. Everybody who's joined us absolutely raves about it. It is the vacation of a lifetime. Check it out at ContraCruise.com. Hey everybody, Tom Woods here. Going to be talking with Ron Paul today. I actually made an appearance on the Ron Paul Liberty Report. Before we do that, I do want to say a quick word of thanks to the sponsor for this episode, and that is the State of Logic podcast. Kevin, the host, brings on intellectuals, comedians, and even the occasional celebrity to talk about current events, politics, business, and a lot more. It's about two-thirds serious, one-third comedy. Kevin himself owns and operates a farm, is a successful entrepreneur, investor, and now podcaster. He intends the podcast to be an example of critical thinking on all levels, so check them out at thestateoflogic.com. Today, I'm reproducing for you an appearance I made, as I said, on the Ron Paul Liberty Report, which you can visit and start watching at or listening to at ronpaullibertyreport.com. Now, some of the stuff in here is a spiel, because we're talking about homeschooling and education. You probably heard a little bit of my spiel on this before, but if you think I'm going to be interviewed by Ron Paul and not featured as an episode of the show, you haven't been following how this thing works over here. So I can't remember the last time I had Ron Paul on this show, but it's got to be at least three, four times. But anyway, I've been on the Ron Paul Liberty Report a couple of times, and I wanted to share this with you. But it's interesting, his humility is so ridiculous that he just refers to it as the Liberty Report. Or the Ron Paul Institute for Peace and Prosperity, he just refers to that as the Institute for Peace and Prosperity. I mean, gotta love this guy. But anyway, I think you'll enjoy it. Whether or not you have children, I think you'll enjoy it, because obviously education and schooling are really at the heart of how the state gets away with what it gets away with. I mean, it's the control of people's minds that really matters, ultimately. So that's what we're going to be talking about today. Hope you enjoy it.
Hello, everybody, and thank you for tuning in to the Liberty Report. With me today as co-host is Daniel McAdams. Daniel, good morning. Good to see you.
How are you this morning, Dr. Paul?
I'm doing very well, good. And we have a special guest today, mm-hmm. and that's exciting. And our special guest is well-known in our audience, and he's been a good friend of ours and in the Liberty Movement. And his name is Tom Woods, and he does a Tom Woods podcast every day. And he also talks about Krugman now and then on a podcast, which is interesting. But Tom is best known as a historian, from my viewpoint, and a political commentator. And he's very prolific on writing, 12 books, and he's just a young guy. So before you know it, he'll be writing as many books as Gary North or more. So he's a New York Times bestseller, which is great. And he has a couple academic degrees from some schools. I think I've heard of them, Columbia and Harvard, pretty good. But the most important thing he ever did in his life was he responded to a request from me to come to Congress and testify and straighten out that Congress. And since that's all been straightened out and everything is okay, Tom, you should feel good that we have achieved so much. But of course, we're being a little bit facetious, but welcome to the program today. We want to talk about the reason why we think homeschooling is a good idea.
I'm very glad to be here. Much happier to be talking to you than to be talking to Barney Frank.
Right. But I want the audience to know that Tom has worked with me and with Gary North in putting the program together, the Ron Paul curriculum. And Tom has done a lot of programs on this. But before we get into the details of the program and what is available to our listening audience, I want to just talk a little bit about the benefits of homeschooling. Tom, it almost seems routine for me on hearing something in the news today, whether it's academic problems in the government schools, whether it's the violence in the government schools, whether it's cultural Marxism. I keep saying, why are people still going to these schools, and why are they not, responding to more homeschooling and private schooling? You want to address that just for a minute or two?
Well, sure. I mean, the advantages are many, and what we're seeing these days is a reminder that passing on your worldview, or at least not having your worldview ridiculed or ignored, is a major factor. I mean, let's face it. the fact is, children are going to be influenced by people, institutions they spend all day with. And if they spend all day in an institution that basically can't stand the sight of you, then we shouldn't be surprised if the kids come not frankly understand how the world works. And I don't mean to say that the object of homeschooling is to propagandize kids, but I do mean to say that that is the object of the public schools. It's clearly to propagandize them. It's clearly to indoctrinate them with a very benign view of the state and to make them suspicious of the private sector, suspicious even of themselves, without the wise custodianship of their paternal overlords. This is not a good thing. And not to mention, I have had many experiences with these institutions. A lot of them are just like prisons, for heaven's sake. The kids hate them. They're bullied all day long, despite the zero tolerance policy the schools pretend to have toward bullying. They don't follow through with any of that. The kids are, the decent kids are terrorized half the time. And the ones who genuinely want to learn are put into, they have to do group projects half the time, which is the biggest disaster in the history of the world. The smart kid has to do all the work, or the loud-mouthy kid winds up dominating the project and doing a rotten job, and they all get a bad grade. The whole thing is awful. Whereas with homeschooling, you can adapt a curriculum to your own pace. If the child needs extra time with something, you spend extra time. If they don't need extra time, you spend less time. You're able to accomplish the same amount in much less time because you're not dealing with all the bureaucracy and all the bad behavior problems and all that that you deal with in traditional school. But I think the reason that you're getting at is why don't more people do this is I think self-doubt. They don't think they can do it. And secondly, they feel like financially it's very difficult to make it work. And I don't want to trivialize that second one. But in terms of can they do it, well, the beauty of the Ron Paul program is that they don't really have to do it, that we've already done the hard work. They don't have to come up with lesson plans or stuff like that. The idea is it's all self-taught. It's video-based, and there are Q&A forums, and the parents can have, if I may put it this way, a fairly laissez-faire approach.
Daniel, do you have a question for Tom or a comment?
Well, I do, and I just want to kind of bring it back to current events because I think there's no better time than today to talk about homeschooling, to talk about not letting your kids be propagandized. And we've seen this march over the weekend, supposedly spontaneously a million kids got together and money fell from the skies to get them all bused to Washington, D.C., saying, please take our guns away. And you saw protests through the schools where the teachers actually told the kids, you better get out there and protest against guns. You're going to get in trouble. So if there's any more time, even if you're opposed to guns, to not let the system brainwash your kids, I think this is it, you know, right now, Tom. And I know you've been watching the events over the past few days.
Well, sure. In fact, I had a public school teacher on my podcast, the Tom Woods Show, over at tomwoods.com, and we had to alter his voice and change his name and not disclose where he's from. But he came on to say, according to the laws practically of everywhere you can think of, these marches that are obviously being endorsed by the teachers, let's not be ridiculous, are illegal because they amount to political and partisan behavior during school hours, which teachers are prohibited from engaging in. Now, of course, we laugh at that because half their curriculum is political posturing of one form or another, but it's not supposed to be this open and transparent that they're just transparently being partisan and taking a position, but that's certainly what they're doing. And of course, the impression that the kids are left with is that this really is the only position, the gun control position, is the only position we even need to acknowledge, because the only other way anybody could think is if they're in the pay of the NRA or something. There is no other reasonable position. And the purpose of that is, of course, to terrorize the other kids into silence. If kids have a different point of view, they are being treated as outcasts. They're bizarre. They're weird. They're dangerous. And to have that kind of chilling effect on a good chunk of the student population is certainly not what a lot of people think they're paying taxes for, to put it mildly.
All right. Tom, I don't want to trivialize the whole issue of the violence in the school and people die and they get killed and there are guns and there are accidents. But I think it is very, very small compared to the bigger problem, which is the lousy education. You describe it as a prison, which many others have. The whole idea that the cultural Marxists take advantage of some types of violence, and also the chaos, the more chaos they can create, the control of the teacher organizations and all these things that you've already mentioned. But, you know, I've been thinking about this, and if you look at the nearly 100,000 schools in this country and the many hundreds of thousands of man hours and these students are going to school, when you talk about real violence, you're talking about a minuscule amount. People say, oh, he doesn't care about it. No, I do, because it's actually used. I think it's, I think the ability to use the gun issue is way out of proportion to the issue of the bad schools. They're not directly the reasons the schools are bad. They blame it all on the guns. And I was just wondering what percentage of people go to school every single day is, and all the problems are there and they're not dealing with the problems. And yet if there's one big problem today or next week out of these many, many opportunities, all of a sudden it gets all this attention. Once again, you know, it is, I don't know whether you can use the word conspiracy, but it's conspiratorial how this can do it. But I think there has to be a lot of money to make those organizations and bring those people together. So, you know, that is it. And, it isn't because there are too many guns in school, and, it isn't the gun, obviously, but I was just wondering if you'd comment on that in the analysis.
Well, yes, yeah, sure. I mean, that you would think that it would be a scandal what a bad education they get, and that's what the students would be protesting about every single day. If just think of it this way: if the private sector had done such a bad job at educating Americans that most of them can't pass basic tests with asking about basic knowledge of science, basic knowledge of math, or of certainly foreign languages. Basically, nobody masters a foreign language in a school setting. So we have that. Basic questions about American politics and government, basic things they don't know the answer to. Now, the way I like to put it is, if Walmart were running the schools and we had results like this, we'd never hear the end of it. The private sector does a terrible job and we need the public sector to step in. But when the public sector is in charge of it, do we ever hear an outcry? All we ever hear is we need more money, more money, more money. And so now it's what, $10,000 a student per year, $15,000? What more do you need? With a chalkboard and chalk, I guarantee you, I could do a better job than these people are doing. So that's the real scandal, is they are putting out, and you know what? I don't even want to say that, because there's an equally big scandal, which is how woefully unprepared kids are. They've been in school, K through 12 is 13 years. They've been in there for 13 years. They get out of that institution, they have no idea how to make their way in the world. They don't know how to balance a budget. They don't know how to open a bank account. They don't know how to find what their niche is in the world. They don't know how to start a blog or a YouTube channel or a Shopify store. In other words, they don't know how to acclimate themselves to the world of 2018. They know how to live in 1957, where you graduate from high school and you either go to college or sit by the phone and wait for a job offer to come in. But they don't know how to promote themselves with the greatest tools in the history of mankind available to market yourself, build an audience, build an income. They don't know how to do it. They have no idea. They have been totally unprepared after 13 years in that institution. What they certainly do know is what words they're allowed to say and what opinions they're allowed to hold. Oh, they got that message loud and clear. But how to actually support themselves. And that, again, if I may promote the Ron Paul curriculum, one of the benefits of that is that we do teach them how to start a small business, how to get a presence online, which is the greatest marketer's dream in the history of the world, how to write effective advertising copy, which is a skill that if you have, you will never be poor. We teach that, and we also teach learning how to be financially responsible to teenagers. We teach them personal finance. Who is getting that kind of background in a public school? The answer is nobody.
Well, Tom, I have to say it's not theoretical for me, because we've always homeschooled our kids. We have one that's about to graduate from high school and get his 2-year college degree in the same week. So that works out well. You have a lot of flexibility. We have two younger girls who are also doing homeschool, and we use the Ron Paul curriculum, so I have to have full disclosure here. But I have to say, you know, the idea that it's a monolith, that homeschooling is a monolith, you have to do this, you have to do it just like school, but do it at home. There are, that's the beauty of it, really, that we have found, at least. There's no one size fits all. You can use a little bit of Ron Paul curriculum. You can use a lot of Ron Paul curriculum. You can use other things. You know, it's all about, for us at least, it's been all about letting the student, letting the child get to where they need to get. But very importantly, and this is critical for parents who care about the development, the intellectual development of their children, it is about history. And my son did Tom Woods for history, and he got a good background in real history, not funny history. And it was kind of funny because then when he went on to the community college and he got some courses that had a little bit of the leftish, a little bit of the spin on it, he said, no, I know that's not right. You know, I learned this from Tom Woods. I know what these guys are doing with this. I know where they're going. That's what you want for your kids to have. My two cents.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, what I was able to do in these courses was distill what it took me 25 years to learn and put that into one or two semesters. And, you know, because you have to read an awful lot of books. I didn't have an eyeglass prescription until I went off to grad school and started reading and reading and reading. So I've read them. I know the good books, the bad books, the reliable historians, the unreliable historian. I've done all that. Why would you want to duplicate that effort? I wouldn't wish that on my worst enemy. I've already done it for you. So then I went and I recorded hundreds of videos. The idea is you just watch a little video every day. 5 days a week, you watch a video. You learn a little something, and I've made it so that the audio is downloadable. So the parents, you know, maybe on your commute, you might want to know, what is my student learning today about history? And I've made it so that adults won't feel talked down to. I want it to be at a level that high school kids can get, because I do the high school courses. But I want it to also be something where the parent could listen and say, hey, you know what, this isn't half bad. And maybe you have some good dinner time discussion. But you're right, Daniel, that one of the beauties of homeschooling is that you don't have to follow some Prussian model where your kids are sitting in little desks and at the bells that go off at certain times, and they're, you know, whatever, they're in a line with a tray to get some milk and whatever. You don't have to do any of that. I mean, maybe today you watch a documentary instead of, you know, reading in a dull textbook, which, by the way, the Ron Paul curriculum doesn't use textbooks because they're the worst way to convey information ever invented by man. But another day you go to a museum, another day you do this or that. Just today, just before I started talking to you, I've already, I had one of my kids come up and we do math. I just do math with her because I love math. I'm a geek. I miss doing math. I was the captain of the math team. I miss it. And she's so quick that I don't want her to be bogged down in a class setting. I want to be able to just move. I say, oh, look, I'm going to teach you this concept. She gets it instantly. So why should we do 500 problems on it? We do 10 problems. She aces them. She does them in 5 seconds. Why would I want to structure it the same way I would structure it for somebody who struggles in math? The beauty is the flexibility.
Well, I want our viewers to realize, Tom, that you and Gary North came to me, you know, in 2013, just after I had left the Congress, with this proposal. And you've been there since the beginning, and you have done a lot of work on this, along with Gary, and making this available. It was very slow starting, but eventually, you know, the program is essentially filled, and I'm delighted with it, and I get so many letters back of the people that are pleased with it. But I think that people should realize that there are these tremendous benefits from this. But you, of course, deserve a lot of credit for this. And you even put a little extra website out to make it easier for people to get to the Ron Paul curriculum. And that's ronpaulhomeschool.com, which is essentially your little link to our program. And I think that what you have done has been just fantastic. And, of course, we want to continue to do this. And we want to continue our efforts to build our program, because you know, if you don't have the students, you don't have a school, and we're doing well. But believe me, the country could be better off if we have this. My oldest son Ronnie told me one time, because he looks at all the things that I've done, and he came up, he says, Dad, you know, he says, I think your homeschooling program is the most important thing you're doing because of the future. And Tom, I want to thank you for participating in this and doing such a great job with the program.
Well, I appreciate that, Dr. Paul. And the site that I set up is called ronpaulhomeschool.com. And if you go there, you get a quick intro to the program. I give you an overview of it. And I throw in a lot of bonuses too, to make it almost irresistible. I have a whole bunch of free things I give you at ronpaulhomeschool.com. But I honestly think it's the most important thing I've done. And I've been around this thing a long time, and I've done books and speeches and podcasts and this and that. But what could be more important than making what turned out to be hundreds of videos on government and history, a lot of times on topics that are just not going to be covered, or they're going to be mangled, or our point of view won't even get a hearing. Whereas if you take one of our courses, you'll know what the standard view is, but you'll also know what our view is. Whereas in the public school, you only know one side of the story. We give them both sides of the story. And I've been really glad to be part of this. And I can't tell you how honored I was to be part of it. Because I think that's my legacy, because who knows how long people could be benefiting from this. And I feel like this way, this knowledge is not just languishing in my head. What good does it do the world? It's just languishing there. I want to spread this so that we have many, many, many people who have learned good, solid history and government and economics, because what more does the world need more than that?
Right. Daniel has another question.
I would just finish with a little anecdote. You know, at the time we started with the Ron Paul Homeschool, my son was about 13 or 14. My girls were, you know, 6 and 9, 7 and 10, something like this. And when we'd go on a long drive, you'd have a 6, 7, 8 year old saying, put on the Tom Woods history lecture. You know, the little kids were enraptured. They enjoyed it. So it really is, it's an enjoyable thing. It's an enjoyable way to learn history.
Tom, I want to thank you very much for being with us today, and I appreciate all the hard work you've done for homeschooling, and I'm sure you'll continue this effort.
Thank you very much for having me. Always a pleasure to talk to both you gentlemen.
Very good. And I want to thank our viewers for tuning in today for a subject I consider very important. Please come back soon to the Liberty Report.
All right, everybody. I have a bit of a controversial site to tell you about. A lot of my listeners create websites and blogs, and I like to help them get a boost, and one of them is called meddlingcatholics.com. And the idea here is that this is actually run by traditional Catholics who are pretty appalled by what's going on in the Vatican these days, and they harness satire and general fun to try to fight back against it. And he says that the creator says that the name meddlingcatholics.com comes from the old Scooby-Doo tradition. You know, they would vanquish the villain who at the end would say, I would have gotten away with it too if it hadn't been for you meddling kids. Well, it's meddlingcatholics.com, and I think you will enjoy that. So I'll link to that at tomwoods.com/1129, as the listener website mentioned. Do give them a look. And of course, remember, you get publicity like this, plus membership in my bloggers group and a lot of benefits that will help you learn quickly and get up and running as a successful blogger. How do you get those goodies? Check them out at tomwoods.com/publicity. All right, watch for a great, great bonus episode this weekend, and I'll see you next week.
Become a smarter libertarian in just 30 minutes a day. Visit tomwoods.com to subscribe to the show for free, and we'll see you next time.